Hi, I'm Tom Coffin, CEO and president and co-founder of Simply Reliable Incorporated. Welcome to the SmartPRENEUR podcast. What's a SmartPRENEUR, you might ask? Well, a SmartPRENEUR, in our opinion, is someone that focuses on working on their business, not just in their business. And our SmartPRENEUR podcasts are designed to bring you some relevant information each week about your business and different parts of that business. It could be marketing, it could be workflow, it could be labor, it could be business operations, many things that we'll talk about each week on the podcast. You can also check out our SmartPRENEUR blog at simplyreliable.com. And of course, our SmartPRENEUR podcast is brought to you by Simply Reliable, makers of Smart Office and Design Machine, the complete end-to-end solution for business process for systems integrators. So thanks for joining us today, and I hope you enjoy the show. Our guest this week is Marc Bally, CEO and founder of Rize Marketing. Marc has been in the AV industry, the custom industry, the security industry, and the marketing industry. Welcome this week's guest, Marc Bally. Well, hello, Marc. How are you today?
Good, thank you. How are you doing, Tom?
I'm terrific. Couldn't be any better. What could be better than being with a good friend like you and all of our SmartPRENEURs who are going to be eager to hear all about the cool things you're going to talk about today? All right, SmartPRENEURs. As I said, we've got Marc Bally with us again today on the SmartPRENEUR podcast. And Marc has a new blog out this week, and I was really shocked, to be honest with you. So it's called What is Google Eat and Can It Help Your SEO Score? So first of all, I didn't even know Google was in the food business. I thought this was pretty cool. So Marc, you know, where do I get these Google Eats? You know, do they taste any good? No, but seriously, folks, they're really not in the food business. So Marc, would you detail for us really what EAT is all about with Google? It sounds pretty exciting.
Yeah, definitely. I don't know. They might be kind of in the food business, and we are the food because they'll if you don't do this correctly, they'll eat you for lunch and your business. So yeah, I guess Google Eat EAT is just a convenient acronym to use and something that you can easily remember, but. Google Eat is kind of the general guideline to help you build your business, rank your business online, and it stands for expertise, authority, and trustworthiness. So we can start looking at each of these pieces individually, but expertise, Google wants to know that you are an expert in your business. So if you're doing home theater, you know, how does Google know that your business is an expert in the home theater business? Well, all Google can do is look online, read your website, and try and determine what kind of an expert you are. So if you have a few hundred words online that talk about, you know, your home theater business, Google probably has no clue that you're an expert. But if you really work on your website, building, adding content the whole time about home theaters, everything from the page about home theaters to blog articles on home theater, configuring home theater, calibrating home theater, and again, just keep on adding stuff like that, have people with reviews on home theater, all of a sudden Google will start to think, maybe these guys are an expert in home theater. but yes, that is the only way that you can tell Google. I mean, you can set up a Google business profile account, and that's very, very, very important. But even there, there's only a limited amount of stuff you can put in about home theaters. And it doesn't necessarily make you stand out, especially if you're in a crowded market where there's 10, 20, 30 competitors. Mm-hmm. But, you know, the rest is the I guess keep on reinforcing to Google that you know what you're doing. And
what about like what about like Cedia
credentials?
Yeah, credentials and stuff like that. Does it recognize stuff like that? Does that help you at all?
It helps you that you're listed in Cedia because Google does know Cedia is about, you know, home technology, home automation, home theater. Mm-hmm. That's a little part of it. That actually comes more onto the next part, under the authority.
Okay.
So the authority part is now works hand in hand with the expertise, and that is, what do other people think about you? And this comes down to, obviously, Google doesn't go interview other people. They will look on what other websites talk about, you know, how many links are coming in, what the quality of those links coming in from other websites. So Cedia, being listed on Cedia, maybe even being part of, you know, being more active in Cedia, that'll definitely bring you those authoritative links back. You know, the same is if you can get your articles in the local newspaper, do work with builders, get listed on builder sites, anything like that that is an authority. Now, just going and putting it out on a blog somewhere that's in, I don't know, Hong Kong or somewhere way out there is actually a bad thing to do, because Google straight away recognizes that's what you're trying to do and gives you negative points for that and says, you're trying to scam us. So the authority part is, you know, like the expertise is, you obviously say you're an expert, but do other people who have good ratings also think you're worthwhile mentioning? And that is the authority part. That's, actually very difficult to get and takes a lot of work, and not that the expertise part doesn't also, but it's much harder to get, you know, good links coming back to you.
Right.
Now, the last part of this is the T in EAT, is that's the trustworthiness. How trustworthy are you? And that's usually comes from, what do your customers think of you? So obviously the number one place is Google reviews. You know, Google loves those. So yeah, that's where your Google Business profile account, used to be called Google My Business, comes in. And there people come and leave reviews and say you're a great guy or you're not. You know, your company is awesome or it sucks. Google reads those. Very, very important. Now, the question is that we always get asked is, well, how many reviews should I get? And Google is looking for 5 to 10 reviews a month. That's a lot.
That's a lot.
For our industry, that's, unless you're really large, that's virtually impossible to get.
Yeah.
So, you know, our recommendation is if you can get 1 to 5 every month, continuously, that will help you a lot. Obviously, if you can get more, even better. But that is another thing Google looks at, is how often do you get reviews? You know, do you make an effort and for 6 months you're getting lots of reviews, and then all of a sudden you get lazy and stop, and it takes, you know, a year to get some more reviews? Google notices that. Actually, that's one thing, not just in reviews, but in website updates and online activity that Google looks at. There's, I don't know, 1.5 billion websites are in existence, or probably more by now.
Yeah.
But a lot of those are dead websites, companies that have gone out of business, but paid hosting for 5 years. You name it, you know, people who stopped, just retired and didn't take it down because, I don't know, they didn't feel like it. So right. Google's looking to see, are you keeping stuff updated? And if you regularly update stuff, including the reviews, then yay, you know, you're around, you're active. They'll definitely help rank you. So, yeah. And it's not just Google reviews that you can leave that help you. It's all sorts of places. Travelocity is another one that we see a lot of security companies use. I don't know. It's kind of strange. But Yelp is another one. Obviously, that's harder. People like to use Yelp to leave negative reviews only.
Yeah.
I think that was the whole founding purpose of Yelp, to kind of scream about your bad experiences. But anyway, that kind of goes into how do you build your ranking. You bring all that together, you bring your expertise, your authority, and your trustworthiness. And as long as you continuously work on it, whether you do it in-house or you outsource it, you get a marketing company to do it, doing this is a critical part of your business to be ranked. Google has no other way to rank you without kind of seeing what you put online.
Right. It seems like this e-concept is a bit nebulous. How do you measure it? How do you know how well the things that you're doing are improving your situation?
There are tools that you can use. Most of them, unfortunately, are paid tools that will go out and they will see how many keywords you rank with on Google. But in general, I think you can see that by the traffic coming to your website. You can use Google Analytics, which is a free tool that should be installed on every website. And, you do an email blast. You can kind of read, see how many people come back. You put up a new blog post, you can see how many people are reading it. All that is available in Google Analytics, and it's all free. Mm-hmm. It does take some digging. And as of July 1st, Google's putting out a new version of their Google Analytics, while making it the primary, because it's already been out for about a year. That is actually, unfortunately, quite a bit harder to read through and figure out than the older version.
Right.
It's kind of a beast. You got to build your own reports, and it doesn't kind of give it to you as easily. But Google says it's got better information in it.
Gotcha. So how do our what are maybe three ideas that if the smartpreneur wants to get out there and improve their EAT situation on their website, what would be the first three things you'd tell them to do?
Well, be enthusiastic about your business and make sure that everybody knows it through your website. But that comes in articles, blogs, adding that. Writing FAQs are a great way. Listen to the questions your customers are asking. And, if people keep on asking you the same question, then maybe it's well worth it to put that answer online. You can put it on your website. You can also put it on your Google Business profile so that people can see it right there. Keep up with your reviews. Make sure. Keep asking people. Obviously, don't ask the guy who just, hates you, because you'll get a negative. Respond to your reviews, even good ones. Say thank you. It was a great pleasure doing business with you. Google pays attention to that too. So it's really a work in progress. The way we like to think about it is that your website is your best salesperson. He's a salesperson who never sleeps, never shuts down, is there the whole time for you, always helping you in the middle of the night or in the middle of the day when people are looking for your services.
Mm-hmm. Great. Well, thank you, Marc. It was wonderful being with you today.
Well, I hope it was informational. And if you have any, want to learn more, or are interested in helping with the EAT side of Google, you can give us come visit our website. It's abs, rize.com. And we've been around since 2008 and done hundreds and hundreds of AV and security companies, help them rank better.
That's great. Well, smartpreneurs, I hope you enjoyed that today. I found it fascinating, and I'm feeling a little hungry now. I don't know about you. So I'll probably go get something to eat after this, I think. And maybe work on my own eats. We'll see. So again, Marc, thanks so much. Smartpreneurs, thanks for joining us. Again, you can read the Smartpreneur blogs anytime at simplereliable.com. Just go to resources and click on Smartpreneur blog. And you can subscribe to it so you can get updated each Monday when they come out. And of course, you can join us on the Smartpreneur podcast each Wednesday as well by going to simplereliable.com, resources, Smartpreneur podcast. Or, of course, you can listen to these podcasts anywhere that you'd normally listen to your other podcasts. So thanks for joining us, and we'll see you again next time on the Smartpreneur podcast. Have a great day. Keep on selling.